back in the 80s into the 90s, a procedure was developed called a laser procedure. And basically, we're doing a version of that laser procedure nowadays. The way we do the laser is we take a small, about 3.5 millimeter introducer. We use ultrasound to help guide that through the mom's abdomen, through the uterus, into the amniotic sac. What we then can do through that straw is we can put a small camera, about a 3 millimeter camera. And then what we do as a team is we use that in utero camera. We actually follow the blood vessels. It's almost like taking a highway system where you jump on a highway, you take every exit from it to look to see, are there connections between the babies? We want to leave those highways and exits that are just for one of the fetuses alone, and we only want to treat the abnormal connections between the babies. You take that laser, you fire it on those abnormal connections, it causes the blood to stop flowing there and essentially separates those connections to effectively turn it from one placenta into sort of acting a little more like a two placenta situation. After we're done doing the laser procedure, we always take a look several times to make sure we didn't miss any connections, we treated connections, and then we usually also reduce amniotic fluid from the recipient twin to, again, decrease that preterm labor risk, decrease some of those manifestations of the disease. Whenever we're counseling a patient or a family, we tell them that we would prefer to never do in utero procedures because we know that that has risks with it as well. So we want to make sure the benefits of a procedure definitely outweigh the risks of the procedure. So we think of two things when we're doing a laser procedure. One, overall time of the procedure. So time in which we put the camera first into the uterus to removal of the camera. We want to keep that as low as we can. Then the second thing we think about is being efficient with our laser. And so after we've gone through and we've mapped those vessel connections, we usually map another time or two to make sure we have a good understanding of exactly what those vessel connections look like. And then when we do the laser, we do our best again to treat as thoroughly but as efficiently as possible. We know that if we can treat those vessel connections in less than 5 minutes, we know that those outcomes look very good as far as survival of the babies. But really what it comes down to is we want to be as thorough but efficient as we can. We want to be in there and out of there as quickly as we can, as safely as we can.